Hello, are you ready for a fun science experiment on our fun Friday? This is called crystal lollipops. Chemistry isn't just incredible, sometimes it's edible too. These crystal lollipops are a delicious introduction to some very lickable chemistry concepts. You will teach your child about saturation, evaporation, and crystallization with a simple kitchen concoction that will leave her hungry for more chemistry. This is a pretty simple experiment, but it will require an adult to help you as you're heating things up on the stove. So here's a list of some items you will need: measuring cups, the stove, a pot and a spoon, a funnel, plastic wrap, 2 cups of water, 4 cups of granulated white sugar, a glass jar, popsicle sticks, and a clothespin. So here are the directions for how you create your crystal lollipops. First, you're going to dip your popsicle sticks into water, getting them wet on both sides. You're going to sprinkle your sugar onto a flat surface and roll the popsicle sticks around in the sugar, coating the stick on both sides, and this will create a place for the crystals to start growing. You will turn the heat on the stove to medium and place the pot on your stove. You're going to carefully add your 2 cups of water to the pot, allowing it to come to a full rolling boil. Then you will stir in 1 cup of sugar into the water. Use your wooden spoon to stir it in until it's completely dissolved. Then you're going to do the next 3 cups of water one at a time, stirring them until it's completely dissolved. Once this is finished, remove your pot from the heat and allow it to cool down for 10 minutes. Next, help your child put the funnel onto the glass jar and pour the sugar water into the jar. Carefully put your popsicle sticks into the jar. Now cover it with plastic wrap, poking holes so that the popsicle sticks can come through. You will find a cool place for the jar to sit undisturbed overnight. You're going to allow the crystal lollipop to sit until the desired amount of sugar crystals are formed. Crystals will begin to form in about 3 hours. So that's why it's a good idea to leave it overnight so that you're not tempted to kind of mess with them. And then in the morning, you will be surprised by how many sugar crystals are on your new lollipop. Then you can remove the lollipop from the jar and enjoy your scientific treat. So this is something that you can eat. It's just sugar and water. So how in the world did you make a crystal lollipop? So what's going on here? Heating the water forces more sugar to dissolve than could possibly do so under ordinary conditions. This process leads to supersaturation, which is what happens when a chemical solution contains more solute or substance that helps create a solution than is typically possible. When the mixture is cool, the water can no longer handle all that extra sugar. After you pour the lollipop solution in the cups, the water evaporates and the sugar crystals remain. Sounds like a great activity for a fun Friday. If you are able to make your own crystal lollipops, we would love to see pictures in the comments below. Try it out and have a great fun Friday.